Silhouette 2025 new 3D environments gives artists a new level of freedom to handle everyday paint and comp tasks, like doing 3D inserts, stabilizing, or painting on unprojected surfaces. Let's check out some of these use cases in action. The latest addition to Silhouette 2025 is the new 3D scene node, which provides an environment where you can load scenes with a tracked 3D camera. You can either import an FBX or Alembic file received from the MatchMove department, or use Mocha Pro directly in Silhouette to do the camera track yourself. And that's exactly what we're gonna do today. This shot is fairly straightforward to track. There is enough camera parallax, and the boy only takes up a small portion of the frame, so he shouldn't cause much of a problem. I'm not going to bother with any extra masks and head straight to the Camera Solver tab and click Solve. And here's what we get. The features and the HPX error looks good. But it's important to align the scene in a way that makes sense, since this will be crucial later when we start creating cards. I'd use the features on the ground to align the ground plane orientation and set the scene origin. Lastly, I'd use the scene transforms to rotate the scene so it lines up with the bricks pattern. That looks good. I'll export the camera as FBX and close Mocha. Back in Silhouette, I'll import the scene file which is saved into a 3D scene node. Now all the feature points should appear directly in the Silhouette's viewer. You can switch between different scene views using this drop-down menu. Pick a specific camera angle or check out the scene in the quad view. Now that we have the 3D scene, we can start placing some cards into space. First, select a group of features along the surface plane where you want to work. Then, choose the card tool and click and drag to create one. You can move, rotate, or scale the card with the associated tools in the toolbar. Alternatively, you can adjust the card's parameters in the object properties. If you want to create another card on a different plane, just highlight a new group of features with the Select Points tool. The tiny green lines that show up when you select points give you a visual clue about the plane's orientation. I select the card tool again and draw another one on the ground. These cards can be used in a variety of ways. One is, you can use cards to insert, match move, and stabilize in the transform node. Connect the 3D scene node to the data port and select the card surface directly in the transform node. If you want to stabilize, connect the source footage to the image input. The image will be stabilized based on the motion of the selected card. If you want to match move or do an insert, set the appropriate mode in the transform node. Then feed the image you want to comp to the first input, and it will follow the card's motion. This method is especially useful when you need to composite on the surface you can't track directly, due to reflections or transparency, like this glass wall on the right. If there is enough data to get a solid 3D camera track, you can create a card on a nearby tracked surface, then move and rotate it into the place where it needs to sit. Another way to use cards is to stabilize and unproject directly in the viewer. Select the Stabilize icon above the viewer and the Stabilization toolbar appears. Choose the card from the list you want to stabilize around, then toggle the Enable button to turn stabilization on or off. You can choose to either stabilize the image alone or stabilize and unproject it, which lets you view the surface as if the camera were facing it head-on. This allows you to paint on a surface without perspective distortion, as if you're facing it directly. This method is undestructive. Image pixels are not modified, only the viewer is stabilized. Connecting the 3D scene data port to the paint node lets you auto-paint and match move strokes based on the card's movement. In the paint node, select the card surface in the transform menu. Then, in the auto-paint window, enable the match move checkbox and auto-paint the strokes throughout the sequence. Once viewer stabilization is turned off, the strokes will appear normal and match moved to the sequence. However, stabilizing the viewer alone might not be enough for more complex cleanup work. If your shot requires more than just a paint node, it's better to unproject the image itself using the new Unproject node. The Unproject node takes two inputs: the source image and the data from the 3D scene. Let's try cleaning up one of these manhole covers to illustrate the workflow. The cards I have on the scene right now don't align with the area I want to work on. So, I need to create a new one that covers the manhole and some of the surrounding areas. Just like that. Now in the Unproject node, I can pick the desired card to unproject along with how it should be displayed. There are three options to choose from. The image can be stretched while maintaining the card's aspect ratio, displayed as a square, or stretched to fit the entire viewer. Let's stick with the last one. The surface motion is now stabilized and unprojected, making it much easier to work with. To create a patch, let's find the frame with the least amount of defocus. I could try painting out the manhole with a clone brush, but keeping the brick pattern consistent can be a bit tricky. So here's how I'm going to approach it instead. First, I'll add a swap channel node and set the alpha to black. That's because the unproject node generates an alpha, but I only want the patch itself to have one. Then I'll create a roto shape just below the manhole, comp it over the unprojected image with the composite node, and use a transform node to reposition the patch, trying to match the brick pattern as close as possible. Adding some blur to the roto shape will help fix the hard edge. There is an obvious color difference between the patch and the surrounding area, but that's easy to adjust with the color correct node. I increased the brightness and toned down the saturation. Then I used another roto shape as an obey mat to limit the area of effect. I also keyframed the brightness at the beginning of the shot to help it blend better over time. Lastly, there is a moment where the area we're patching from goes out of frame, causing an ugly black edge. To fix this, I'll add a hold node and freeze the last good frame before the edge appears. Then use a switch node and keyframe the inputs to transition at the right time. The final step is to reproject the patch and composite it over the original plate. For this, we use the Reproject node, which restores the original surface motion. Just fit the unprojected image to the first input and the data output of the Unproject node to the second one. Then with another composite node, comp the reprojected image over the original source. Since we set the alpha to black earlier using the swap channel node, only the patched area is affected. I repeated the exact same approach to create another patch for the second manhole cover. And here's how my final result looks. And that's it. Silhouette 3D environment really opens up a new way to handle paint and comp tasks. Hopefully, this gave you a clear idea of how to fit it in your own workflow. I'm Elizabeth Postol for Boris FX. Thanks for hanging out with me.